Right, I think I'm live. I am live. But hopefully it'll let people chat tonight, because it didn't do that last night. So yeah, we Oh, it would have helped if I turned that on, wouldn't it? Right, that should work now. So yeah, we're in the middle of October. Let's just close our bedroom door. And let's hope it's here. It's ready for harvest. However, my harvester is all the way over on field 5 from our last harvest job. What else have we got to do? We were going to do a little more forestry. Look at that golden sky, that's blinding. The loudest harvester in the world is chirping up. So yeah, let's I don't know which side of the road I'm going to be driving on this. I'm assuming it's going to be this one. If I see a car overtake me, then I know I'm on the wrong side. But however, I chose the right side this time. But yeah, it's been a weird one so far. However, it's been enjoyable. But yeah, we've got to get started on the harvest sooner rather than later. Oh, wrong button. I'm hoping that's not just affected anything. It hasn't. So it's not this exit, it's the exit next. And we cut a few of these down last night as well, just to pass the time a bit. I always get a little bit laggy in this location because of all the trees, so cutting them down might not be a bad idea. Well, there's a beautiful field. And then we'll go over to the... Well, we'll first see what the corn's looking like. How's this looking? Still growing. Oh, we can look at it through here, can't we? Ready to harvest. And still growing, apparently. That sucks. And we'll go and have a look at our oil rig. Say that term loosely. Oh, what's going on here? Oh, I'm stuck there. And at least we've got a direct entrance now. We don't have to go all the way around the world. Now the pointy stones. From here it looks like little jets are flying off. Right, so we're going to cut the field down the middle, or we're going to be a little more strategic. I'll cut it like this. Wow, this can actually see over the corn. Oh, this ain't even corn, is it? This one doesn't grow as high. So yeah, we've got all this to do, then we've got all that to do, and then... I mean, it's not going to be a mega amount that we're going to get off this, but it's going to be enough to give us a few, maybe about 60 grand. Right, so we'll headland over here. I mean, we are getting quite a lot though. Quite happy about that. Oh, we missed one. We got one lone flower over there.
Right, I'm back again.
Sorry, I was just explaining some scientific stuff to a friend about if you throw a ball and it lands in the exact location. It's not exactly in the exact location. Right, up we go, and then we'll start doing the ups and downs. Might need to headland again up there, but we should be able to get away with it like this. We're just going to cut through this way, because we need that extra overhang to counteract the indentation that we've made in the line. Probably go one more overhang, actually. I know what you're thinking, well, now you just made another indentation. We'll fix it. But at least we've not destroyed our crops yet. That's always a bonus. And now we're cooking with gas. And I'm not going to make that joke 3 streams in a row. But yeah, we're nearly 50% full now, which is a delight to see. We are hammering it home with these. So yeah, all we've got to do now is just focus really well on this. Oh, wait a minute, hang on. It's got top chat enabled rather than live chat. Now this may have caused me to meander. I don't know, I didn't make the English language. Look at that, straight through the hedge. Oh shit, we're destroying crops. I forgot to lower the header. So now all of my sunflowers have died beneath me. Well done, Fiasco. You've nailed it there. The reflection of the sun onto this is actually really doing my head in. It's making it quite difficult to distinguish the rows. Right, so let's try and not make the same mistake again. But yeah, we passed the halfway point in terms of capacitor. So it nearly did 10% that way on. But yeah, I'm thinking this one is going to be the Sugar Beets Field the next season. We've got the wheat planted, we just need some lime. But that'll be next year. We're going to gradually introduce them into it. But yeah, while we're at the end of this run, I'm just going to have a look at this new DLC. The Forager, or the Hay and Forager pack. Ooh. So do just attach a mower onto that. So these are tractors. Oh, that's a nice little truck. It's got a front hitch as well. And the roof setup. I'll probably have that there. That's 137 grand. You don't get much for that though, do you? I mean, it's a pointless tipper. Twenty-six horsepower, 4 meter working width, 4 miles per hour. Oh, you can get a windrower version. The mower's 4, and that's 2. And they'll have adjustable stuff. So that's a front mounting mower. 7 meters wide. And it looks like it has swathing capabilities. Jesus. It's only 9 meters wide, that's 14. That's very expensive. Multifast, what's that? Mm. multitasked. So does that mean it will move around? And that's another, well, it looks like a mower with a windrower bit capabilities. 9 meters for 125 grand. Seems like a bit of a rip-off, to be honest. But yeah, that's, well, I'm going to look at. It looks quite expensive. I mean, it might be something we'll look at doing as we go into... I mean, is it going to TED for us? But it's hay and silage pack. But then again, silage means it'll cook grass rather than automatically produce hay. I mean, it might be something that we look at using on a different save game, I don't know. I mean, if the equipment came up in the second-hand market, I'd probably look at buying it. But that would be nice. 27 grand. I mean, it would be nice, but we can't afford it yet. Because we've still got so much that we need to build towards. And I think getting the header and leasing the harvester would probably be the better thing to do so far. And then, when we've got ourselves a mower, we can then look at the possibilities of branching out into purchasing the harvester. Because we're going to get a lot of grass, and we're going to get it by the bucket tons. And with the graze mod, animals will eat the grass, and Cavalier Roy obviously has that included. But it's going to be quite interesting to see where this takes us. Because the cows alone will end up taking up a lot of our time. I mean, everything's going to take up a lot of our time eventually anyway. The sheep are going to be like the least maintenance, the lowest maintenance animal. But yeah, I might need 2 auger wagons as well. I would just don't do cut sugar beets for now, but I kind of want to because they add the most amount of money. They double the profit that you earn from it. Please don't fill up. Right, so we're going to get the tractor. to get the car off this. Oh, in fact, no, we can just keep travelling, can't we? Because it'll automatically lift anywhere. So he's nearly full now. So he's actually gobbled up a lot of that field. Way over half of it. Yeah, I'm definitely looking forward to getting my chickens in. You know what? It would help if I bought the trailer. How many times have you done that? Right, so this is nearly empty now. Look at that, almost a perfect straight line. Is my boomer still out? No. So yeah, we've got just a little bit longer to go now. Not too much longer though. Not too much longer. Which is really, really good to see. But yeah, it looks like we're going to be depending on the second-hand market for quite some time now. Oh, here we go, autosave. Because if we look at this, sugar beets, I've still got a couple more months left. And sunflowers, so I've, that's corn. But then again, corn's got one more month left, so it should be ready to harvest next month. It looks like we're going to get completely finished off within like the first hour of the day, so we're going to have to turn to maybe a couple of contracts, because not only does that bolster the money a little bit, but it also just gives us a couple of jobs to do, because there's nothing worse than just sitting around going, right, we've done that job, right, let's skip on until we can actually do something else. Like, we'll try and keep up momentum. Yeah, let's crash our harvester into the fence. Why not? Gotta keep the mechanic on his toes. Oh, we've dropped a few frames, that's not a good sign. 32 out of 60 per minute. 60 per second even. 60 per minute would be fucking slow, wouldn't it? One frame a second. I wish our driving was less drunk and more precise. That'd be nice. That would be nice indeed, y'alls. Onwards we go, upwards to Glover. I am going to harvest these rows that I've missed because I've got a feeling that there's quite a fair bit of grain there. Oh, not grain, seeds. Yeah, they do produce a lot of seeds as well per plant, like hundreds, hundreds and hundreds, maybe even thousands. And sunflowers can be used in so many dishes as well. Use it in soup, you can use it in bread, make seeded loaves. And obviously, you'd add stuff like pumpkin. And look at this, we're going to get some ghost. What they call sunflowers. I don't know why the game does this, but if you go over like a blank plot like this here, because I think it's supposed to have them in here, but it's just not visible. So if you do see these lines in your field, harvest over them. You never know what you're gonna find. And by my experience, it's always been more hidden sunflowers that have not rendered. Well, if it's more than one row, then you're not going to get much or anything. Right, so then we get this little bit over here, then we just go back around. We got an extra 200 litres off all of the shit that we missed. So that's pretty good going. Oh, that tree is going to be quite problematic. But then again, it'll be on the down motion, won't it? So it's not going to be too bad. It'll be tree bad. I shouldn't make jokes. I don't have that sense of humour. And chop, 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 chop. So here we've got, like, nearly 20,000 litres of this shite. It's not quite as good as the, what did we harvest before this? Was it oats? Oh no, it was canola, wasn't it? Not quite as good as the canola. But it's not been bad. But yeah, let's just dump this in here. Oh shit, we're fucking... I don't give a shit whether the auger's extended on that. I just want to take this to the mill. Right, onwards we go. I mean, eventually we will branch out to a telehandler. But telehandlers just work a lot better than front loaders. Open the production menu. So it's still got quite a lot of canola in there. How much oil have we actually made? Holy shit, I need to spawn that. 3 pallets. Let's get this going. Let's go to the shoop. Where's my self-made wooden trailer? Is it on the bale loaders? There it is, the hay wagon. Auto loading, no straps. Straps, no auto loading. And I don't know where this logo is. Let's go old logo, head rack. No. That's 8,000. And we're going to get more than 8,000 off all of this. So it's a wise investment. And we'll also take into the shops for repairs as well. We've got the perfect size. Whoa, 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 you wait for me, my friend. The turning on this is actually really, really, really good. Okay, it's actually quite... It surprised me, really. Look at this car right up my ass. Stop tailgating me, my friend. I'll do what you do to me. Big check. Nail. They're not even close, actually. He's actually staying quite back. That's nice of him. Another trailer. And it's got the fucking... pivot axle. Bastard. A complete set of bastard, yeah. Here comes traffic. Hello, you. You look like a Skoda. Like a Skoda Octavia, maybe, but just without the secondary colour hood, it's not two-tone. Hello, kitty cat. How are you doing? Ah, How's life treating you? Right, you're supposed to give away, you stupid fucking prick. I'm playing on Jabbar's favourite map. Holy shit, we dropped so many frames just then. Yeah, doing good. Hubby having trouble sending you messages on here. Is he subscribed? Oh, has he got an account? Is he logged in? Each side is going to decapitate us. Comes with an error. That's really, really weird. What's he trying to type on? Right, you fit perfectly in there, so why are you not? Right, come on, let's drag you. There we go. Oh shit. Right, we possibly need to wait. You've got to wait. I don't understand why it would come up with an error message, though. Oh, sugar tits. It says create a channel to join the chat. When we press, it says an error occurred. Well, the channel, please try again. Is he logged in on... Like, what's he trying to watch it off? Which device is he using? Is he using his laptop or is he using his Oh Jesus Christ, that's dancing. YouTube app like you. I don't know what I could suggest then. Has he tried? Does his app need updating? Hello, Leslie Cox. How you doing? How's life treating you? Let's just turn them nipples off. Oh, that's his other account. I wonder why it's not letting him send it from his account then. Oh, just check. Let me just check something. According to YouTube support, it says live chat features is only available on YouTube watch pages, not on embedded players. So I don't know what the fuck that means. Alright, stop dancing. That's not really setting the palette far properly, is it? So what settings has it got different on that then? This is why I like front loaders. This is why I hate front loaders even. Hey Jabbar, it's working. How you doing, my friend? Stop dancing. Why are you not coming off? So what's causing the problem then? Yeah, look at this, Jabal. We've struck oil. Literally, we've struck oil. Stop playing ball though. Hello, Jabbar. It's like you say hello. Right, so we're not in a position where we need to quick sell this just yet. But yeah, we've got nothing else to do this month. That has nothing left in it. But yeah, we were done in the first hour with a month. Harvest sugar beets and take it to Maypole Exports. Harvest potatoes and take them to farmers market. Nothing really worth doing, is there? There's absolutely nothing worth doing. Hello, Jabbar. Oh, wait a minute. That one works better than... Right, so, is it working properly now for you? It's got your green logo now. Yeah, got my... profile photos right too. I wonder if that was just an issue on YouTube's side then. Right, we're in November. The cursed month. Yeah, sussed it. Ah, fantastic. I'm glad to hear it. How are you doing anyway? Right, so that's not ready. That one is, though. So the bad one's ready. The good one's not. Which means... let's go unrealistic. Oh no, we're buying this, aren't we? Ah, fuck me, how much is that gonna cost? 20 grand. Fuck it, we're gonna have to, aren't we? So how you doing anyway? We're gonna need more than fucking warning signs for this, aren't we? Let's look at the sheer size of this beast. Yeah, that's right. Stop dead for me. But yeah, look at this thing. It is huge. So what have you been up to recently then, Jabbar? Right, it's time. Holy shit, that's way too quick. Fucking hell, 27 miles an hour and ripping it apart. I've never done beats on this field before. New experience. Break. Ah, I should have cut more of these, shouldn't I? So, Jabbar, what have you been up to? Speak to me, Jabbar. Spike. Oh, is it broken again? Okay, now we're already on 44,000 litres. Holy shit, this is steep. Come on. Come on, tractor. Come on, harvester. Come on, whatever the fuck you are. But I just got one curiosity thing. Is this killing crops as I'm going down there? I'm gonna turn crop destruction off for this job because it looks like we were killing some crops. I've not even pressed the accelerator button. Fuck, let's just knock this down a bit. Because it's ridiculous speeds at 26 miles per hour. So you're still there, Jabbar? Litres and counting. Think about your headland one more time before we start trying to attempt the ups and downs. Oh, I might go left and right actually, as it seems a little more spacious. Yeah, it's the last month of corn and it's still not grown yet. Now, I'm not going to be bitter about it. But I'd rather like to have the corn. A 100,000 litres. And that's only 20%. What the fucking hell is this upgrade then? Oh shit, wrong button. Let's go down a bit slower. We got a lone sugar beet there. We've got loads on this side as well. And we're probably not as spaced out as we would like to be. And downwards we go. We're trying to beat it now. $129,000 this shite. But yeah, I thought 250 was the capacitor. Has it gone up to 500,000? I remember when I had quite a few of these little machines on this map. Pummeling and pummeling away at sugar beets. Right, let's just have a look at how much this holds. Yeah, 500,000 litres now. When did that change? It used to be half that. Either Jabbar's having more issues or he's passed out. It is getting late, to be fair. But yeah, if not got that much left, actually. In the grand scheme of things. I mean, this is fucking quick as well. I don't understand how I'm missing, like, little fragmented rows when my head is covering everything. Unless it dips out of that section a little bit, I don't know. Let's see. And down we go again. Let's go and pummel this to death. 15 miles per hour, nearly 200,000 litres too. And what I think I'm going to do as well is, I'm going to keep a hold of this. Oh shit, what am I doing? I'm going to keep a hold of this and do a couple of sugar beet contracts. We at least the equipment, just so we got a bigger trailer. Holy shit, 21 miles per hour, but dropping significantly. But yeah, look at everything that we're missing. I think I might just do a whip around. And there it goes, and then let's go down here. Look how fast these cutters are going. They're going so we got most of it in a couple of runs. It's another sweaty night. And daylight is becoming upon us as well. So we're going to get more sunlight soon. But yeah, I can't wait to get this harvest out the road. Because this one is the most time consuming by far. Yet we've missed a row there again. What I think I'm going to do is I'm just going to fragment it. this is what I normally do with sugar beets. I don't know why I've not done it with this one. But yeah, 220,000 litres. I've probably got another like 50,000 litres in there. No, in fact, no, probably not 50,000. But I think what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to leave them as they are, rather than get the sugar beet cutter and sell it. I'll just wait until I can afford a sugar mill. So yeah, it does mean that the fruits of our labour are going to become a little more unknown. However, we will get much more bang for our buck. I mean, we're going to be producing sugar pallets, so obviously we're going to get shitloads. Oh shit, we've missed bits. Right, it's up as fast as we can, and it's gonna slow right down. And again, we've missed bits and pieces over here. But we're not gonna make the same mistake over here. 27 miles per hour. We have a top speed of 25. But you know what? I might not be far off when I said I've got another 50,000 litres in here. It's looking very likely. Right, onwards we go. Nearly there. L later. Holy fuck, we're going so fast. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Now. And we've got little strands there that we would need to harvest as well. I might think, oh well, you know what, they're not that much in the grand scheme of things, but they are a couple of hundred litres. I reckon on the steepest section we can probably reach about 30 miles per hour. Because getting 2 miles per hour over our speed limit. Oh fuck. We've gone way off course there. And we're going down, 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 down. And not in a good way. In fact, it is a good way. Oh fuck, we're going way off course though. Let's just keep trimming this side. We actually have done so many sugar beets, it's unbelievable. I mean, I might just cut these and sell these, because it would produce a massive swath of money. And we've only been doing this for half an hour now. Things you can do with the best money and technology you can purchase. That wasn't even the correct sentence. The things you can do when you can get the best technology available. So go and get these little lovely little tiddly ones. Look at that, the lizard logo on the steering wheel. It actually fits the part, to be honest. I do like that logo. potentially one of the best logos ever fitted into a game for a sort of, what should I say, standardized, unbranded logo. But yeah, look at how little we've got left to do now. And down, 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 down. And where's the other missed runs? Up here. So, I mean, next year this will be a wheat field. Because we want to get the chickens sorted. And down we go again. Down the world of a ducky. Right, onwards we go. Ah, so close, we can almost taste it. Oh, very, very close. Now let's get the rest of this. Nearly 400,000 litres. So I said we probably got around about 50,000 litres. We had 100,000 litres remaining in the field. That's some pretty good beating. I mean, no sugar. I didn't mean to swear. And you know what? We've probably got enough for around. In fact, no, not. I'm gonna say we've probably got enough beets for a nice round 400,000, but we've not. And there we have it. That is the harvest completed and depleted. Let's bring this out. Excellent. Ah, shit, we didn't want to bring that there, did we? Let's just push this into somewhere. Will it fit in there? Just about. You can always super strength it out. But we've got that done and dusted. So what we're going to do now is go to here. 6 grand for that, that's fine. And we don't really care for that one. But it's not even close to its what it should be. Because that car's going to die by next month.
I think we need to do some jiggery pokery.
Let's go car on. Ready to harvest. Cloud, yes, it will have been. Weeds, no, and lime, no. And there we go. So let's just, oh, he's still running. Fucking hell, they've ran out of a fuel nailer. Right, so let's just go on to the toilet. And then we'll finish off with the harvest. And then we'll call it a day there, then. So let me just run to the toilet first. Right, it's back time. So we're going to head over to the field. It's going to be nice. We're going to get some corn. We're going to sell that corn instantaneously. We could forage it and make silage, but we're not going to do that. That just takes too long. We don't need silage yet either. I think this will be our sugarcane field. But yeah, this field is weirdly positioned. So it won't make any sense to do it in first person. Because it sort of sits at a diagonal setting. Don't ask me why. It's just the way it is. And we've purposefully gone for the lower yield with the what's it called? With the developer tools, because we could have easily just made it all green, like the best harvest we'll possibly get from this. But we've not. Yeah, I think we could actually get the sugar mill in December, depending on how well this grows and stuff. And I think I'll probably put this in a farmer's market or supermarket actually, because then we can get another 50 grand. We know how much we like these collectibles. Absorbing all of them in 1 year doesn't seem like it's sufficient though. It's not sustaining anything. But I don't want to get corny, but yeah, we've got corn. And it's naturally telling us that we need to go in this direction as well, this field. I'm going to do two headlands because the shape is weird. We're 65% full now already, and we've hardly touched the sides. Which is where I'm presuming how the Thirsty Tide comes from on your headland. Obviously, that's where it comes from. Because you're literally touching the sides. We're nearly there now. And I mean, we've nearly got a full harvest of that is. We're not even close to this yet. I mean, we are, it's not a big field. This is why we're opting to do sugarcane on it. And I'm happy that I remembered to go to the correct clockwise position. Oh, buggery bollocks. Let's get the trailer out. Right, so what we're going to do is we're just going to pump all this in. And I'm thinking we might fill this trailer at some point during this harvest. Power Tube is a very, very good trailer, I'm not going to lie. It served me well in so many bouts that I've ever had. But then again, so is this class. This class has been class. It's been a classic piece of kit. I mean, look at it go. It's like 25 million miles to the gallon. Joking, it's like 2 miles to the gallon. I see the arm. Had a bit of a weird angle. But I see it. And I want it to go all the way at the back. So that way it doesn't stump our perspective on how full the trailer is. Oh, we've got a couple of extra liters on there as well. So 12,504 litres, what a very weird number. But yeah, corn is very tall. They need headers, they need harvesters that actually go tall in this, because there's a lot of corn accidents in the US alone, never mind the UK. But then again, I can't remember the last farm that I've ever spoke to that ever said that they grew corn. It's always grain. In the UK, that is. Fuck my life, we're missing corn, I don't want to miss corn. Everybody loves corn on the cob, everybody loves corn, everyone loves popcorn, they love sugar. Sweet corn. They love corn. They wrote that song about it. Corn, corn, can you eat the corn, corn? Can you eat the corn, corn? Can you eat the corn on the cob? Fuck my life, this is it's going tedious now. God help us when this becomes bloody sugarcane. I just cannot wait for the rest of this. Ooh, 97 subscribers. Where the fuck has that come from? Two more. We are three away from 100 subscribers. Please subscribe. 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 I think one's Kit Kat, one's probably Jabbar's count alter ego. Three away from 100, though, is a fucking awesome achievement. Getting 100 would be fantastic. I love all of y'all. Yeah, look at that. There's like no systemic approach to this. It's all diagonal. Which is kind of annoying. Yeah, we're actually nearly an hour into this month and we've still not finished all the harvests. But we're not too far away. This is the reason we love Maypole. We just get the job done all the time. We're nearly full again. But yeah, we're definitely going to fill this trailer. I think we can make it to the top. Even warm can't pop feel cold on this treacherous, humid night. But yeah, at least we can still harvest properly now. But yeah, it's actually a weird position though, isn't it? Because it's sort of diagonal from everything else as well. And there's a few fields like that as well, which really, really frustrate me about this map. It means that you've got to do them yourself. We can't just depend on AI unless we do like fields in the north corner or the east corner, well, the west corner. Well, in the eastern side actually, besides 50 and 27. Ah, you're taking the piss. Right, let's lift this. Let's cut down some of the old dribbly bits. Because he's nearly full now. Not filling, and it's looking like we're just gonna have to get a class farm besides obviously the forager. I mean the beets harvester. It's raising up now. There we go, I'm actually at the point where the pezoint. Yes, the pezoint. I'm at the actually the pezoint. We're actually at the point where it's gaugeable now. Nearly full. But then again, we've nearly finished this harvest as well. So thank you to all those who subscribed tonight as well. It's been absolutely incredible. Right. Nearly there now. Oh, fuck off. I mean, bugger off. I love this harvester. I actually do. It's been absolutely fantastic so far. Damage is minimal. Yield is quite high though. But we can bypass that from how much it's freaking harvested over the past 3 months. Yeah, look at this one go. No stopping it. Absolutely no stopping it. It's got like 300 horsepower. And I've got a tractor with more pull power than this. Because it managed to miss that bit. I'd never understand how it's managed to miss that. But yeah, harvest is nearly over, thank God. Another 7,000 litres nearly. I managed to get everything around it besides that one little bit. How? Fuck my life. This is taking forever. But we got some more shit to sell. And I was thinking of leaving it into storage, but I think I might just sell it straight away. The supermarket likes corn. They love the corn petals. You know what? Yeah, let's just go with this side. It doesn't really matter. In a few years' time, this is going to be sugarcane. Okay, it looks like he's wearing like a little blonde afro. The Milky Bear kid was strong and tough. This will definitely fill. Oh, maybe not. Ah, well, no, if you're not filled yet. You were 35 litres away from filling. That just seems a little bit cruel. Give me. Oh, there's an extra three. Will this fill? I think it might. It did! Huzzah! This is the very first full load we've ever done. We'll take it to the farmer's market. Not the farmer's market, the superstore. I know there is a... Oh, Jesus, this is excruciating. I mean, everything's in my blind spot right now, so who knows what's going on. But yeah, it's pummeling through this. So we're going to go all the way to the supermarket, sell all this on, make some cha-ching. This corn was made for eating, and that's what they will do. One of these days, these corn is going to go straight to the supermarkets and be eaten by you. And here comes the supermarket. Is corn not accepted at the supermarket then? Oh, so we're looking at potentially a grain elevator. How far away are you? So how's the grain elevator then? Oh, right next to the shop. Well, I thought I was going to get lucky there and get with the... Something sold there, so we can get the collectible. But now we've got to go all the way to the grain elevator. Excruciating, I know. Oh, we're going off target there. We're going off target. Yeah, I know not what I do. Oh shit. Oh fuck. We survived. Don't give a shit about traffic. We're just gonna go. My nipples are blazing, so you know, we don't need to abide by the law, do we? Look at all this corn. You gotta love corn on the cob. If you don't, then you've not really got it together. So where are we going then? There's a sugar mill. But this is the grain mill. But this was the oil mill actually. What does it say up there? Can't really read it. Yeah, it doesn't really say much. But I think there's a collectible here. If I remember rightly, this is the shop that we can actually enter. So we've got 16 grand for that header, that trailer. Oh, wait a minute. Oh. But no, unfortunately, no collectible. That pipe's not real. So we're going to go and collect the rest of the shite. And by shite I mean corn. Oh bugger. So we're going to go and collect all the corn. And then... I think we'll just sell our oil. So we can get the sugar mill. But sugar sells for a very, very high price. I'll go down this one this time. Honest to God, we just need to sort everything out, really. Yeah, there's not going to be a great deal in there. That's going to switch off. So, like, we'll look at flour. I mean, we're not doing flour, but I mean, it's 1,000. We'll look at canola oil. 5,000 per pallet. And then where's sugar? It's not going to cost all this junk. Ah, well, it's not doing too well, actually. But 5,000 per pallet is actually looking pretty frickin' appetizing. We might sell that. Because then we might actually have enough money to buy the sugar mill. Because we've got, what, 5 pallets? Could be 6 by now. Then we'll have some sunflower on top of it as well. I think canola would be much more expensive than sunflower. And I am correct. We've got more pallets. So at $5,000 a pallet, this isn't actually looking too bad. It's actually looking extremely profitable. So we'll just sell all this then. Oh bugger. But now I think this one can hold on to a trailer. Got the right connections. Oh, it can. So, canola oil. Maypole exports, here we go. I think Maypole Exports is at the south of the map. I think it's the like very, very bottom one. $5,000 a pallet. Who could resist that? I mean, we're gonna be made. But absolutely fucking rolling the door. Oh, 6 miles per hour up this hill. Well, at least we got the beacons on. Oh, it stalled. We're going to go down in speed, but you know what? Up here, we're going to go pretty quick. Jesus Christ, it's 20 past 2 in the morning. Oh, Jesus. Over to Maypole Exports. Yeah, Maypole Exports. Has a ring to it, actually. Got a long line of traffic ahead of behind us. And look at it, three cars. We got a three car build up, breaker. But we are getting there. We can see the beacon flashing across the trees. Now, I know from experience, there is no collectible here. I have searched high and wide for one, and I've never found one. First produce. Yeah, oil is produce. That's most of canola worth it, isn't it? Well, we did a good job there. Right, well, that's all we've got time for tonight. We'll look at figuring out what we need to do for the next month. Jesus, I've had a blast. So let's start the stream. We'll see you all tomorrow.